Greetings, I am the cartoon hero. By now, making fun of Cartoon Network's bad decisions has almost become a cliche online. After the heyday of the cartoons, Cartoon Network seemed like they were struggling to find an identity. With characters as iconic as that, after their shows got canceled or finished, whichever the case, any network would have trouble finding their footing after losing some of their star players. But that's not to say that I think everything Cartoon Network has released since then was crap. Then I'd be Ben the Loony.
Who?
Trust me, you're better off not knowing. Sure, I was annoyed that shows like Megas XLR and Teen Titans got canceled, but Cartoon Network has shown some genuinely great series since then, like Regular Show, Adventure Time, which I haven't seen as much of as I want to, Steven Universe, which is pretty unique in a good way, and DreamWorks Dragons, which seems to be the only DreamWorks movie that Nickelodeon didn't get the rights to make an animated series out of, and coincidentally also the best series out of them in my opinion. True, Nickelodeon didn't help matters by canceling the Kung Fu Panda series, the best DreamWorks series they had, but then again, Cartoon Network has said that the new DreamWorks Dragon series will premiere on Netflix instead of their actual channel, so I guess we can call them even now. Their other shows, well, Uncle Grandpa can be funny, I never cared for The Amazing World of Gumball, and then there are a lot of reruns and reincarnations of Hanna-Barbera shows like Scooby-Doo, which has a new series coming, though honestly I don't know how they can follow up Mystery Inc., and the new Tom and Jerry show, which, while it might not be as good as the original shorts, isn't really that bad in my opinion. Teen Titans Go! Yeah, I don't have anything good to say about that. I don't hate it, it's just kind of draining to me. And then there's Clarence. Yeah, I don't really need to say anything about what happened, right? So yeah, Cartoon Network, like Nickelodeon, is a mixed bag now. And I'm aware that this isn't a network targeted at me necessarily, but the fact that I can enjoy at least some of these shows gives me hope for its future. And trust me, the See and Real period was a whole lot worse. It's not just the idea that Cartoon Network aired live-action shows that turned me off, it's that these shows just seem like rejected refugees from Discovery Kids. If you combine Dude What Would Happen with Destroy Build Destroy, you'd basically end up with a poor man's Mythbusters. And trust me, watching Mythbusters would be much more worth your time, even without the Build team. Seriously guys, what the fuck? Hole in the Wall was basically a Japanese game show. And that's about it. But then there's the subject for today, a movie that's been requested up and down to me, and a movie that I really haven't been looking forward to talking about. Reanimated. What's Reanimated? Imagine Who Framed Roger Rabbit, minus all of the iconic characters and insightful social commentary. And then add meth. That'd pretty much give you a basic idea. Reanimated is a horrible movie that spawned a horrible series, and the worst part is, it's bad in a way that's almost difficult to talk about. What do I mean? Well, as much as I don't want to, it's finally time for me to answer all of those requests and revive this movie so we can kill it again. This is Reanimated.